Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our service today. The Lord be with you. Our service today follows the theme of discipleship, following Jesus, serving God, and service to one another. And also of using the gifts that we receive from God, and using those gifts for His glory and not our own. I also thought this week it would be appropriate to give our wonderful musicians a well-earned rest this week. So our music this morning comes from the archive which we have built up over the past few months and from some choral resources provided by St Martin's in the Field in London. In our service today we are joined by Pauline Coulson and Carol Robinson who will read for us, Reverend Heather who will preach, and we will be led in prayer by Joe Breslin. As we begin our service, let us still ourselves before God, and we say the prayer of preparation together. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you, and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we have our special prayer for today, the Collect. Let your merciful ears, O Lord, be open to the prayers of your humble servants, and that they may obtain their petitions. Make them to ask such things as shall please you, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. So we begin our musical offering today with a song which reflects the faith of the humble servants mentioned in our collect. This is the story of Joseph as he submits to God's charge to be the earthly father to our Lord Jesus.
Can a man be father to the Son of God. Oh, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king? Could it be sleeping in my arms? Sleeping now, so peacefully. The Son of God, the angel said, how could it be? Father, show me where I fit into this plan of yours. How can a man be father to the Son of God? Oh, for all my life I've been a simple carpenter. How can I raise a king? How can I raise a king?
Brian and I recorded that song some months ago in his carpenter's workshop, in his garden. And I really hope that we will be able to sing that as a congregation together this coming Christmas. As disciples of Jesus Christ, living out our faith is something we are not able to do on our own or in our own strength. We accompany one another and are upheld and loved in all that we do through the love of God the Father, in the grace of Jesus Christ, and with the guidance and strength of the Holy Spirit. Sometimes those things we do fall short of the life we wish to lead. Yet we are assured as people of faith that God will forgive us. Jesus said, before you offer your gift, go and be reconciled. As brothers in Christ, in God's family, we come together to ask our Father for forgiveness. So we pray. Father, we have sinned against heaven and against you. We are not worthy to be called your children. We turn to you again. Have mercy on us. Bring us back to yourself as those who were once dead but now have life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to the everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So now we come to our time of scripture, and Pauline reads our New Testament reading for us this morning from Paul's letter to the Romans. Thank you, Pauline.
A reading from Romans chapter 12. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. For by the grace given to me, I say to everyone among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body we have many members, and not all the members have the same function, so we who are many are one body in Christ, and individually we are members of one another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us: prophecy in proportion to faith, ministry in ministering, the teacher in teaching, the exhorter in exhortation, the giver in generosity, the leader in diligence, the compassionate in cheerfulness.
Thank you, Pauline. Our next hymn is sung for us by the St. Martin in the Fields Choir. Officially titled The Summons, most of us will know it as Will You Come and Follow Me?
Thank you.
What an uplifting song that is. And now Carol will read from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 16, verses 13 to 20. Thank you, Carol.
Now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." Then he sternly ordered the disciples not to tell anyone that he was the Messiah.
Carol, thank you for that reading, and thank you too for the setting. So this morning we welcome back Reverend Heather, who will preach to us this morning. Thank you, Heather.
Good morning. In the 1964 children's classic, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, Roald Dahl gave us this eccentric Mr. Willy Wonka, owner of a chocolate factory which produces the most renowned confectionery in the world. His decision to open his factory to 5 lucky children for a day was actually a calculated plan to find the perfect child to take over his factory. Mr. Wonka is searching for someone honest and worthy to whom he can teach all the secrets of his factory. And as we know, Charlie Bucket proves to be that boy. And in a sense, the story is a moral tale. For each of the other golden ticket holders symbolises some kind of excessive lifestyle. Augustus Gloop is greedy, Violet Beauregard is self-centred and only interested in chewing gum. Veruca Salt is spoiled and Mike TV watches television non-stop In the course of their tour of the chocolate factory, the obsessions of these children lead them away from Mr. Wonka and the main prize. Mr. Salt's wealth could do nothing to prevent his daughter's disappearance down the rubbish chute after her selfish attempt to steal one of Mr. Wonka's squirrels. So all these children, due to their excessive lifestyles, miss out on getting to know Willy Wonka, even though all of them are invited to get to know him. And in our gospel reading today, Jesus asks his disciples a question. Who do you say I am? And it is Peter who responds. He recognises who exactly Jesus is, as he says, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." His declaration of faith is affirmed and rewarded by Christ, as he says, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it." Faith reveals Christ to Peter. They're not all as certain as Peter. He is the only one to assert what he believes. The other disciples present reports to Jesus that some say you are John the Baptist, and others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets. Jesus is adamant that the disciples should not tell anyone who he is. Thankfully, God is watching and waiting, ready to affirm our faith when we come to that realization of it all for ourselves. I wonder, would Peter have volunteered his declaration of faith in Jesus as the Christ if it hadn't been asked the question? We can imagine that whatever Peter was doing during the first part of their conversation, whatever direction he was looking in, it was at that moment that he is looking directly at Christ, who has Peter's full attention. As he says, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." A declaration of faith like that is made with while looking someone directly in the eye. And it was as almost as if at that moment the rest of the world stood still and quiet. It was a moment when nothing else mattered. How often do we make the time to be quiet and still? We are invited to come to know God, but in the modern world it's easier to become distracted by and the obsessive about things that really are unimportant. The children in the story were too focused on themselves, and they didn't consider what Willy Wonka was offering. And for us today, I know technology is marvellous and it does bring us great benefits. But very often we use technology rather than speaking directly to family and friends. And what about those journeys that we all go on? Physical journeys can be spiritual ones. And often on the train, for example, we sit and look at our phones as the world passes us by. This is perhaps a rather sad metaphor for life. But if we put aside the noise of the world, train journeys can provide time to sit and reflect and pray. There is something to be said for staring out of train windows and meditating on God's creation. If we want to find God, then we have to put aside other distractions and look for him, for he's ready and willing to be there for us. Amen.
Thank you, Heather, once again for opening the word to us. So we come to our time of affirmation of faith. We are children of God. We are upheld in the Spirit and loved by Jesus the Son. We stand together as brothers and sisters in Christ and declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. We say together, we believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So now we come to our time of prayer, and Joe Breslin will lead us this morning. Thank you, Joe.
Let us pray. Lord, hear the prayers we offer as we come to you in these uncertain and unsettling times. Please grant us strength that we may live our lives courageously in the certainty of your love, while never forgetting the needs of all your children. Heavenly Father, we pray for peace throughout the world, that we live together in harmony, whatever our differences. We pray especially for asylum seekers and refugees everywhere, that they will be welcomed into new communities, safe in their surroundings and free from fear. Please guide our world leaders to govern with wisdom and compassion, knowing that their decisions are for the benefit of all, and not to further their own personal ambition. Lord, we thank you for all that you have provided for us, our homes, families, and community of Quarrington. Thank you for enabling us to continue to meet as a church family through these changed circumstances. For the ministry of our diocese, especially the work of Reverend Mark, Al and Heather. We are grateful for all our blessings. Help us to appreciate all that we have and to be aware that others in our community are not as fortunate. We continue to pray for a time when everyone will have food, water and shelter and the opportunity to sleep without fear for tomorrow. Lord, we pray for those who are sick in body, mind or spirit. Please give them courage and strength in their distress and comfort in their sadness. We especially remember all those who are victims of COVID-19 or any natural disaster. We pray for baby Isla and Isabel and their continued recovery. Bring all who suffer your love, be their strength and support until they are brought aid and relief. Father, we ask for peace of mind for those who are caring for a family member or who are mourning the loss of a loved one. Thank you for the continued labours and dedication of all the medical and care staff who tend the sick and for all the hard work of our emergency services. Lord, we have not cared for the world that you gave us, and we continue to destroy your creation. We have chopped down trees, polluted the rivers, the seas, and the air that we breathe. Help us to change the way that we live, that we can care properly for the environment, so restoring it to an undamaged world for current and future generations. Lord, be with us in the week ahead as we try to live our lives through the example of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. We offer our prayers to you in his name. We say together the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Joe, for those prayers. Our next hymn is brought to us once again by St. Martin in the Field Choir, and it is Lord for the Years, thinking of all those wonderful things that our Lord God has given to us.
Oh,
We hope that you have been uplifted by our worship today. Of course, the ministry team understand that in these strange times, we might be experiencing things which are quite different to what we are used to. As always, we offer to you our support, our prayers, and our love, and remain available to you should you wish to speak to us or talk something through. Our final hymn this morning is written and sung by Sue Tuck, and it is called May Your Ways. Taken part in our service this morning. It's always wonderful to see you all. So as we come to the end of our service, I wish you all a wonderful and blessed week ahead, full of God's grace and God's love. And we ask God the Father for a blessing to send us on our way. Be of good courage. Stand firm in the faith. Do everything in love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and all whom you love, this day and always. Amen.